welcome back to Inside Boxing's Throwdown. I'm Aurelio Martinez, Steven Johnson, and this is our third and final segment of this week, where we're going to kind of cool down a little bit, and we're going to talk about an upcoming fight that has the attention of all boxing fans, and it's, again, it should be a very good fight.
Yep.
And hopefully Adelaide Bay won't be in there scoring.
Her name's Adelaide Bird, man.
I don't care.
Leave that woman alone.
But what happens when you don't respect somebody, you don't give a shit.
Hey, okay? Madison Square Garden.
We're not talking about that anymore.
Vasyl Lomachenko and Guillermo Rigondeaux. You know, you got two amateur world champions. Both of them two-time amateur world champions. Both of them two-time Olympic gold medalists in a super featherweight fight. This is going to be awesome. I mean, on paper. The reason I say it'll be awesome on paper because both of them have kind of boring styles, right?
Well, they're both defensive fighters. They're both mobile fighters, defensive fighters.
Mm-hmm.
So you're right. I mean, it has all the markings of are we going to
on
see
paper.
On paper? Are we going to see a lot of movement and less action,
mm-hmm.
or will one of these guys actually step up and bring it to the other boxer and provide some action?
Well, it's going to come. Yeah. That's going to fall in the lap of Lomachenko because we all know that Guillermo Rigondeaux from Cuba is a just a defensive specialist. You know, that's his thing, is counter punching.
Yeah.
And so Lomachenko's going to have to bring it. You know, he's the one who's been running his mouth saying he's the best in the world, that he wanted it. And then Guillermo Rigondeaux, you know him, he doesn't mind chattering a little bit. He stepped right up and said, okay, if he wants me, he can have it.
You know what? In Lomachenko's last fight, I saw a little break in his armor. Okay,
you did.
I sure did. Because you know, if you sit there and listen to all the commentators and all the not the officials, the commentators,
mm-hmm.
and the writers, the boxing writers, and everything, mm-hmm. you know, Lomachenko was
the greatest thing since sliced bread.
God's gift to boxing. Okay,
that's right.
But true fans and people that follow the sport and people that are in the sport know the real deal.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. He still has to be proven.
That's right.
Okay, and in his last fight, what he showed me is that he's quite a bit of ways from being proven. Okay, because mm-hmm. he went after I forget who it was, but he went after the guy very hard, tried to put him out, couldn't.
Yeah.
Okay, so when he realized he couldn't succeed, and he realized he wasn't who he thought he was,
mm-hmm.
he resorted to clowning. Okay,
yep.
And that's an action that's a mid of submission. Okay, I can't knock this guy out, so I'm going to clown and act like I'm putting on a show. Okay, but the truth of the matter is he couldn't accomplish what he went to do in the ring. Okay, so that showed me something. He's not going to clown on Rigondeaux.
No, he's not.
Okay?
No.
That's not going to happen. Okay, you've got someone that's been in the ring just as long as he has had as many amateur fights as he has, and knows the game. The only difference is Lomachenko got a age advantage over Rigondeaux. So the question is going to be, is can an older Rigondeaux sustain the action like when he was a young Cuban superstar?
I don't think it's going to be a problem for him. I really don't. And I base that on the fact that Lomachenko is not really battle-worn. You know, I mean, mm-hmm. he's a... for all indications that I've ever had, is that he's a gym rat. You know, I do question whether he's 36. I think he might be 40, you know, but he's a small guy. And with the smaller guys, it doesn't matter that much. But Lomachenko's been running his mouth. And I don't mind saying, and I'm going right off the bat saying that I would love to see Guillermo Rigondeaux knock Lomachenko out. You know, Lomachenko, like I said, doesn't mention the name of what's the kid from Washington? I can't remember. He doesn't mention it. There are several guys, you know, that deserve a shot at him. But like you said, especially Lampley and that crew, they're all about he's the greatest thing since sliced bread. So let's see him get in there and go with Rigondeaux. Since Rigondeaux is promoted by Rock Nation Sports,
then
you got, once again, now here comes Bob Arum. Okay, so yesterday we had Tom Loeffler and K2 Sports and then mm-hmm. Oscar De La Hoya, Golden Boy Promotions. Now here's our next group. that comes up. We'll get to see. But the good thing about this is that, to me, this fight's going to be on ESPN. You don't have to worry about pay-per-view on this one. It's going to be on ESPN. We're all going to get a chance to see what I hope turns out to be a good fight. But once again, this is going to depend on the undercard, because I do anticipate this main event might be a little bit slow, but the undercard could really make this thing really be interesting. Now, as you said before, fighting in the garden is a big thing.
Well, it is, and I'm going to tell you what, I'm kind of glad to see this on ESPN. Not so much because it's ESPN, but behind it. If you remember, early on in the season, Oscar De La Hoya was bragging about he had this 25 deal with ESPN that's going to take him to the next few years with ESPN.
Yep.
So this man thought he was going to control ESPN.
Yep.
But then you got Papa Arum, who knows what he's doing, come in and say, wait a minute, you don't got control of ESPN. Here, I'm going to show you. And it's proven. If you look at the fights that Golden Boy Promotion has put on ESPN since the contract, and then you look at the fights that Bob Arum has put on ESPN, it's like there's no contest.
Sugar and shit.
There's no contest.
No question.
There's no contest. So this fight, again, has all the makings of being a good fight.
A good fight.
And you know, like what? You say, it's the thought, okay? A lot of people that are really into boxing are really getting soured with this Lomachenko baloney, okay? Show us. Okay, if you're going to talk and put him on this pedestal, show us. We'll be happy to support him.
Yeah.
But you got to show us. You know, like Janet Jackson says, what have you done for me lately? Okay.
Well, I was thinking, I was thinking of Gary Russell Jr. You know, Lomachenko got that split decision, and he doesn't mention his name anymore. But I will be interested to see what he does with Rigondeaux. The biggest thing about Rigondeaux to me, the both of these guys.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, they were amateurs for so long. Okay, that they're both of them now, like you said, at a point where even at 29 for Lomachenko, that's pretty old.
Yeah,
you know.
Well, yo, sure it is.
Yeah,
sure it is.
Yeah. And they're supposed to be at the top of the game, one of them's gonna get knocked off the pedestal.
Think about it. He's 29.
But is Adelaide Bird? She won't be refereeing there, was she?
Yeah, I'd like to see her referee. Get her in the middle of that ring.
I want to see her referee.
Oh, boy, that would give the opportunity of a fighter to kind of accidentally, you know, miss a punch. But anyway, no, it has all the makings of a good fight, and I think we'll probably see a good fight. You just have to ignore the aftermath, because Lomachenko is going to win this fight, okay? Whether he wins it truly or whether he doesn't, he's going to win the fight, okay? It's a Bob Arum promotion. Jay-Z doesn't have the clout Bob Arum has with the networks, with ESPN and HBO and the Showtimes, okay? So, given that, and given the way boxing's been going for the past decade or two, the promoter will select the officials. The promoter will tell the commission the way the fight's going to go, okay? So, barring a knockout, Lomachenko going to win the fight.
Okay, wow.
So save your money. If you're a Rigondeaux fan, I know you love the guy, you love him, but keep your money, okay? Keep your money, because you're not going to win a bet, okay? So it's not
going to win. Well, here we go. Yeah. This is great for me, because I'm going to dispute that. I don't think that this fight carries that much weight with Bob Arum.
Well, it doesn't carry that much weight like the fight we just saw, but it does carry the future of Lomachenko and how much money it's going to put into Bob Arum's pocket.
Well, and that's
he can't lose. If Lomachenko loses this fight, Bob Arum has lost his investment.
Well, wait,
his total investment into Lomachenko, he has to back it up, and then he has to decide whether he wants to go back to the drawing board and reinvest and build it up again. So he'll have a big decision.
But see, we talked about this a couple of weeks ago, and I said, you know, and I'm still sticking with this. Lomachenko loses. It's not bad for Bob Arum. I mean, it's a little chink in his armor, but that just further puts Terrence Crawford as his cash cow. Well, right now, he's got a good little thing going between the two of them.
Lomachenko loses. 10 seconds.
If Lomachenko loses, there's only one cash cow for Bob Arum, who right now is 85 years old.
See, but you don't understand.
I don't understand.
I'm afraid of you.
Okay.
You don't understand. You just don't understand.
I just don't understand.
As good as you and I know Terrence Crawford is, okay, he's not the cash cow. Terrence Crawford will not bring in, right now today, the big pay-per-view numbers, the big thing for Bob Arum, as of Lomachenko would.
Lomachenko can't bring in pay-per-view right now.
What I'm saying right now, he can't. But he wins this fight and he keeps winning. Bob Arum can't afford to put Lomachenko back on the drawing board and rebuild him after a loss.
So you're saying that, it's a foregone conclusion that Lomachenko is going to win?
Yes.
Okay, good. Yes. I just want to make sure, because you did say that.
I was just going to give you a chance to waffle on it.
But I'm saying,
I would love to see Terrence Crawford take that high level, that top spot in Bob Arum's arsenal, but it won't happen because he cannot draw the pay-per-view numbers that a Mexican fighter or a Russian fighter will bring. And it's unfortunate because right now he's the best boxer out there.
Well, the problem is that for Bob Arum, and you would agree with this, with Terrence Crawford, the problem is finding opponents. Nobody wants to fight him. So he's got to move to welterweight, okay? At welterweight, there's a whole slew of guys that can be competitive.
Well, wait a minute.
So they have to be careful with
that.
I'm
going to disagree with you on that.
What?
No one wants to fight him.
At 140.
At 140. No one wants to step into it. But that's the problem of the promoter. That's Bob Arum's problem, okay? Because anyone to fight him, if the money's right. We've already seen that. We've already proven. He can get another champion. He can get another top 10 contender to come in and fight Terrence Crawford on a big show if that guy's paid right, because that's the way it is. You pay someone a few million dollars, they're going to come and fight because people are not going to turn down that payday.
True.
Okay? But when you're trying to nickel and dime an opponent for Terrence Crawford, hell no, they're not going to come and fight this man.
That's what you think is going on right now?
I know that's what's going on.
Okay.
I know that's what's going on. In the business, it's all about money.
Oh, yeah.
It's all about money. And then if you pay
the big money, they'll come.
They're going to come.
Okay.
Okay. That's what boxing is all about. That's what all these Mexicans and Russians and that's why they're in boxing, because they want to get that payday.
Okay.
So they're not going to sit there and turn down, hey, I'm going to give you $2 million to fight Terrence Crawford. You're not going to get a whole lot of no's. You're not going to get it, but the money's not being offered.
How many paydays as Terrence Crawford has been $2 million? See, I'm giving you credit for what you said.
Well, that's what I'm saying. You got to pay your cash cow, too.
Yeah, you got to pay him. He's not there yet.
And it's unfortunate because he should be making that big money.
And, well, don't forget, as of right now, Manny Pacquiao's still not out of that mix.
No.
Okay, so there's a little bit going on there, but...
There again, that would be a good fight. So why won't Bob Arum offer Manny Pacquiao the $5 million? You know, Manny Pacquiao's on the end of his career. He'll take a big payday to fight Terrence Crawford.
Well,
I mean, Manny's ready to go.
Well, he's taking his little hiatus right now so he can be a senator over in the Philippines. But like you said, when he gets that squared away, who knows what that
is. And let me ask you something. Do you think Terrence Crawford would have a problem in going fight Manny Pacquiao in the Philippines?
None at all.
So what I'm saying is the money's not being offered right now for Terrence Crawford, and it's a shame. All right, listen.
We're going to end up today. Hope you like this conversation we had. As usual, editor@insideboxing.com for any questions, any concerns, any topics you'd like us to cover. We appreciate you watching. We'll be back next weekend with a whole new set of topics that we'll discuss. I'm going to find some things that I can thoroughly disagree with you, with the radio, with that you people will agree with me. We'll get into that next Sunday. All right?
See y'all next week, and hopefully it'll be a little more laid back.
Yeah, he's got a little angry today. You know his boy Canelo with that yellow streak. I mean, because you guys remember he took Canelo. That's what it was a shocker. But that yellow streak slipped right back up there on him. So anyway, thanks a lot. We'll see you next week. In the meantime, Inside Boxing's Throwdown.